For the last few months, the spotlight has been on the embattled devolution cabinet secretary Anne Waiguru to step aside over massive alleged corruption in her ministry. And the move to have the cabinet secretary sent home has not been an easy one for the Nandi Hills Member of Parliament, Alfred KETER'S, who is attempting for the second time to impeach Waiguru. KETER'S now claims that Waiguru has been protected by the Jubilee government and has accused President Uhuru Kenyatta of using underhand tactics to derail the motion by using Speaker of the National Assembly Justin Muturi to frustrate the impeachment motion.
The nation is waiting for us to debate in that house. The Speaker must allow us to debate that. He is under instructions from wherever, whether it is State House. We will not, and we are not going to be intimidated. But it is so suspect when you see the protection she's getting, the special treatment, that protection, they will not succeed because Kenyans are running out of patience. They need a revolution to ensure that their resources are well taken.
KETER'S, who is also a Jubilee coalition legislator, claims that Muturi is trying to block the impeachment motion against Waiguru from being presented on the floor of the House for debate. He has accused Muturi of also blackmailing members of parliament to withdraw their signatures. KETER'S claims MPs who have supported his motion have been intimidated and others bribed to withdraw their support.
So all these issues allow members, Mr. Speaker, to interrogate. They have the capability. If that house cannot manage, then there will be another committee of 11 members to go through the issues that are touching on Waiguru to see whether she's innocent or not. If we are meeting the threshold to impeach her or not, it is a subject that should be before that house. So Mr. Speaker must allow us. We want to see that document there. It is no longer a KETER'S motion. It is owned by Kenyans.
He questioned why Speaker of the National Assembly is introducing obstacles even after lawyers from Parliament approved the impeachment motion. KETER'S says he already has over 180 MPs who have signed up for the motion, surpassing the required 88 signatures.
That unlike the previous motion, where members were bribed and some intimidated to withdraw their signatures, this new motion addresses new issues, grounds that raise eyebrows in devolution ministry, like modalities of establishing that we have established on youth fund. That is under our docket. There are issues to do with discrimination in IDP settlement, where some IDPs were paid 200,000, some were paid 10,000.
Pressure has been mounting on Waiguru to step down over the loss of 791 million shillings at the National Youth Service, which is under her watch, and alleged misuse of public funds in her ministry. However, the embattled cabinet secretary has maintained that she will not resign over the graft allegations in her ministry.
This is not the first time an impeachment motion against embattled devolution cabinet secretary Anne Waiguru is facing stiff opposition. But Nandi Hills Member of Parliament Alfred KETER'S says he's sure that the impeachment motion against the cabinet secretary will be successful. But KETER'S has only one appeal to the executive: stop protecting Waiguru. Brenda Czeda in Nairobi.